Welcome to Magic Minutes by MGIC, mortgage industry training that helps you expand your knowledge and skills. Before we get started, take a moment to review our legal disclaimer. MGIC is providing this as general information based on current industry guidelines at the time of this recording. It is always advised that you seek the guidance of your own compliance and regulatory departments.
Welcome to our series on analyzing self-employed income. I'm Sandra Sweeney, Senior Customer Trainer and Program Designer for MGIC. In this short tutorial, we'll continue our discussion of vehicle mileage depreciation by looking at some case studies. We'll go over three real-life scenarios where errors were discovered during the review of files. These will illustrate mistakes to avoid. Scenario number one involves a case where the underwriter conditioned for additional and unnecessary documentation. Looking at tax returns, Schedule C showed fairly large figures on line number 9 as well as line 13. Page 2 of Schedule C, line 44A, was blank. Because this was blank, the underwriter did not include any vehicle mileage depreciation during cash flowing and encountered a problem with a high DTI ratio. The loan officer reached out to the borrower, who indicated that they had used standard deduction. The underwriter then requested auto expense worksheets. When the worksheets were received and reviewed, it was noted that standard deduction was used. However, it should be noted that worksheets are not always completed or required by tax preparers. So this borrower was fortunate in that the documentation was available, as this resulted in additional income of $11,648 for that tax year. But was there already documentation that the underwriter could have used to confirm the use of standard deduction? Yes, IRS Form 4562 was in the original file and showed three work vehicles on line number 30. If the underwriter had added up the mileage on line number 30, the total business miles would have resulted in miles of 44,799. Multiplying the total business miles of 44,799 by the standard deduction rate for 2021 of 0.56, the standard deduction would have been 25,087. Turning back to page 1 of Schedule C and looking at line number 9, we see the same number. This should have been confirmation that standard deduction was used, and the business miles should have been included in the worksheet during cash flowing. Here the findings were: over-documentation of the file and unnecessary conditioning requiring the auto expense worksheets, which may or may not be available. This scenario did have a happy ending, as this particular borrower was able to provide the requested documentation. Moving on now to scenario number 2, involving a case where the tax forms look different from one year to the next due to the business selling a work vehicle. Looking at the 2020 Schedule C, once again, page 2, line 44A is blank. So the underwriter did not include vehicle mileage depreciation during cash flowing. But did the underwriter miss something? Yes, they should have noticed the notation to see attached. The underwriter should have looked for a supporting statement. Once discovered, the attached schedule showed two work vehicles. The total mileage was 59,705. Using the factor of 0.575 for 2020, the total would have been 34,330. Checking to see if this matches line number 9, we see that it does, and therefore we have confirmed that standard deduction was used, and the mileage of 59,705 should have been included in the worksheet. Between the years of 2020 and 2021, the business owner sold one of the vehicles. And therefore, in the year 2021, Schedule C did show mileage of 75,230 on line 44A. By multiplying 75,230 by the factor of 0.56 for the year 2021, we see a total of 42,129, which matches the figure on line number 9. So once again, we have confirmed standard deduction was used. Let's look at the comparison of income calculation. The top worksheet shows the omission of the vehicle mileage in the year 2020. Due to this omission, the total for 2020 was 54,282. And then for 2021 was 61,676. The income trend was then evaluated as increasing, and therefore no additional documentation was required. The second worksheet shows the correct income calculation, as it does include the vehicle mileage that was found on the attached statement. The correct total for 2020 is now 70,402. And once again, for 2021 was 61,676. The earnings trend was actually declining, and the requirement that the borrower provide verification that the earnings have since stabilized would have been required. So the findings for scenario number 2 would have been as follows. A documentation defect was discovered due to a miscalculation of income. As the earnings trend was declining, verification of stability of income was required and was missing from the file. Turning now to our last scenario number 3, which will illustrate how omitting vehicle depreciation can affect qualification. In this example, Schedule C, line 44A was blank. So, no mileage was included in the worksheet, and the qualifying income was $7,707. This calculation resulted in a high DTI ratio that did not meet the mortgage guidelines. However, once again, the underwriter missed IRS Form 4562. As it turned out, Form 4562 was included in the file. It only reflected one vehicle on line 30, which is unusual, but the borrower was required to complete this form due to another type of special depreciation that was claimed in addition to vehicle mileage. Using the mileage on this form and applying the standard deduction rate confirmed that standard deduction was used for both 2021 and 2022. And therefore, the business miles should have been included in the worksheet, and the resulting correct qualifying income was $8,939. The findings for scenario number 3 showed that the income was miscalculated and was lower by $1,231.86 by qualifying monthly income. The resulting DTI ratio would have allowed for a loan approval. Our recommendations are as follows. Don't neglect to look for business miles on IRS Form 4562 or a separate statement if Schedule C, line 44A, is blank. Take the time to determine if actual expenses or standard deduction was utilized. Remember that all income that is supported should be included, as exclusion could lead to different earning trends, additional documentation requirements, and may result in a higher debt-to-income ratio.
Thank you for joining us for Magic Minutes. We hope this brief tutorial has made a difference for you. For more how-to videos, visit mgic.com/training.